If you're more outraged about Israel defending itself against Hamas than you are about the murder and rape of innocent children, like Iranian 16-year-old Nika Shakarami, you need to re-examine your moral compass. Leaked documents have just revealed what happened to Nika, who was kidnapped by the regime while protesting the murder of Mahsa Amini in 2022. Nika was filmed by regime forces burning a hijab at a protest before being followed by regime security officers. She was taken, shoved into an unmarked freezer van with three men, and brutally sexually assaulted, by their own admission. When she resisted even kicking one of them in the face to get them off of her, they beat her to death. They were then instructed by the IRGC to dump her body, which was found 9 days later under a highway overpass in what the regime called a suicide. Medical examinations also found that she had likely been raped. The report, which was leaked, also showed that the three men were not punished and were members of Hezbollah. The overseeing officer was IRGC. The regime has now arrested Nika's sister as well. More than 550 Iranians were murdered in protests. More than 800 have been executed by the regime in the last year alone. Sexual violence as a method of war is a well-documented tactic by the Islamic Republic against both men and women. And it's also something we see regime proxies implement, like Hamas on October 7th. Sexual violence should never be tolerated as a method of war, yet this is exactly what the Ayatollah and the IRGC condone. In fact, the regime has previously had a policy of rape for women and girls on death row because they cannot die as virgins. Whether from Hamas, from Hezbollah, or from the Islamic Republic itself, no one should be silent about this. Justice for Nika and justice for all the victims of the Islamic Republic.